beef stew and dumplings. For 8 servings you will need 3 tablespoons of olive oil, 10 grams of butter, 2 pounds 900 grams of stewing or chuck beef, cubed, 3 cloves of garlic, minced or thinly sliced, 1 medium-sized onion, finely diced, 1 can or bottle of beer, 2 pints, 1.2 litres of beef broth, that's about 4 or 5 400-gram tins, more if needed, 1 tablespoon Worcestershire sauce, 3 tablespoons tomato paste, 1.5 teaspoons of sugar, 1/2 a teaspoon of paprika, salt and black pepper for seasoning, 2 carrots, peeled and roughly sliced, 2 parsnips, peeled, cored and roughly sliced. To core the parsnip after peeling, cut each parsnip in half lengthways, then in quarter lengthways. Taking care to keep the fingers out of the way. The core can easily be seen at the end of the root. There is also a line down the length of the root on each side. With a sharp knife, cut along each line to the centre of the root. Lift out the core and throw away. This will leave a channel down the centre of the root. If parsnip isn't available in your country, try using sweet potatoes, known as Kamote in the Philippines and sometimes, incorrectly, yam in America. 2 celery sticks, trimmed and roughly sliced, 1 small turnip, peeled and roughly cubed, 200 grams or 7 ounces of small portobello or chestnut mushrooms, peeled or wiped and sliced. Heat the oil and butter in a pan and brown the beef. Brown the beef in 2 or 3 batches. Don't overcrowd the pan. Using a slotted spoon, remove the beef from the pan. Add the garlic to the pan and the onions and cook until softened, about 3 minutes. Pour in the beer. The beef broth. The Worcestershire sauce. Tomato paste, sugar, and paprika. Add salt and pepper, then return the beef to the pan. Cover and simmer on a low heat for 60 minutes. If the liquid level gets too low, add more broth as needed. Add the carrots, parsnips, celery, mushrooms, and turnip. Continue to simmer, uncovered, until the vegetables are tender and the liquid is reduced. about 60 minutes. Meanwhile, make the dumplings. To make 8 dumplings, you need 125 grams of self-raising flour, 1 tablespoon of dried mixed herbs, 60 grams of shredded suet. If beef suet isn't available in your country, use lard, margarine or butter, whatever fat you have. You need to rub the fat into the flour to make a crumbly mixture, in the same way as you would make pastry. If that is too much fat for you, then use vegetable suet, made from vegetable fats that contains no animal products, and a good pinch of salt. Sift the flour into a bowl. Add the suet, salt and mixed herbs. Mix the ingredients together. Slowly add a little water, about 3 tablespoons to start with, and mix in. Gradually add more water, in small amounts, to make a soft but not sticky dough. If it becomes too wet, add a little more flour. Lightly flour your hands and roll out the dough into 8 small balls. They will double in size while cooking. If the liquid is too thin at the end of the cooking time, put 2 tablespoons of plain flour in a bowl. And add a little water to make a paste. Mix well so all the flour is absorbed without lumps. Stir the paste into the stew. Simmer for another 10 minutes. Drop the dumplings carefully into the stew. Cover the pot and cook for another 20 minutes. Your dumplings should be plump and moist, but definitely cooked all the way through. To make sure the dumplings are cooked, insert a knife into the dumplings, and if it comes out clean, they are done. Serve the beef stew and dumplings with boiled or mashed potatoes, rice, or crusty bread and butter.